My name's Jen DeLeon. I don't really know how to explain what I do, but if I were to put it in a nutshell, it's inspirational videos, but my background is working with the hip hop communities. Today I plan on talking about following your passion. I have a very crazy story, and it's a story that most people wouldn't believe, and it was simply because I decided to take a leap of faith, take risks, no matter how scared I was, and I followed my passion, so I'm going to share that story with you guys. I want you to walk outside of this door, making sure that you follow your passion no matter how scared you are, because like God placed that passion in your heart for a reason. Hi guys, thanks for coming out, and thank you to the entire ABS-CBN family for having me. You guys have been such an amazing team, so let's give it up for them one more time. So, before I get started, I want to ask you all a question. What is your passion? What is the one thing you'd love waking up every day and doing without thinking about the money? Because let's be honest, a lot of us aren't doing what we really want to do because there's no real money behind it. Forget about the money. Forget about fear. Forget about anyone who has ever told you you can't do it. Forget about that voice in your head that's telling you it's too late. What is your passion? My name's Jen DeLeon, and the only reason I'm standing up in front of you all today is because I followed my passion. I always knew what I wanted to be since I was a kid, be on camera and have my own TV show. I went to high school, took all the journalism and production classes that I could think of, went to school for journalism and graduated with a bachelor's degree from Columbia College. Learned how to start a blog and a YouTube channel, and that first intro video is not something you want to see. I was the first intern for the Chicago Bulls for Bulls TV, and then the biggest thing was I got to meet and work with Oprah. I went up to Oprah in the green room and I said, "Oprah, I started this blog, I started this YouTube channel, I have no idea what I'm doing or where it's going to go, but I'm going to be the next you, just the Filipino version." She laughed and she said, "Jen, the next me will be you. Just keep doing what you're doing because someone needs to be that voice." So in that moment, that was my confirmation of knowing I was on the right path. I was born and raised in Chicago. Never once in my life did I ever think I was going to leave Chicago and come to Los Angeles, but I'm obviously here. I went to, when you think about when someone asks you, "Why'd you move to Los Angeles? What do you hear?" "I want to be an artist," or "I want to be an actor." Most people have asked me, because of my career, "Did you move to Los Angeles for work?" The reason I moved here is for none of those reasons at all. In May 2012, I came to LA to do interviews, and I had an interview with Kenny Smith's daughter, Kayla Brianna. After the interview, her manager asked me, "What is it that you want to do?" And I said, "I want to have my own show." Usually when I tell people I want to have my own show, people are like, "Oh, that's so cool. What do you want your TV show to be about?" That was not his reaction at all. His reaction was, "Then why are you in Chicago? If you could accomplish that much in Chicago, imagine how much more you can do in Los Angeles, where all the celebrities are and where all the TV networks are." He was right, and I had nothing to say to that. I got on a train to go back to my hotel, and that question really, really bothered me. So I started to pray. And I was like, "God, for whatever reason, I feel like I need to make this decision right now. Do I leave Chicago? Leave my family? Leave my friends? Leave everything I had built up until this point, because everything I had told you guys earlier, I did by the time I was 20. Or do I move across the country, go to LA, no family, no friends, no job, no savings? Please, God, give me some kind of sign, because I feel like I need to make a decision right now." I get off the train, and the first thing I see, this homeless lady, who is probably as far as where the end of the stage is. She's yelling and throwing things at people. And I'm like, "I'm not trying to walk past you." So it's this way. I'm looking over. I'm like, let me try to cross the street because I really don't want to go by her. A train comes. I have no choice but to walk past her. So I'm walking and I'm walking. And you know when you're trying to tell someone, don't look now, what do? They look right now. So I'm walking, walking, thinking, don't look at her, don't look at her, don't look at her, don't look at her. We're right here. I look her right in the eye. She looks me in the eye and she says, follow your passion. And it was in this gremlin, creepy voice that terrified the hell out of me. And I'm thinking, maybe I'm crazy. There's no way that she just said this to me right now. Because sometimes when you ask God for a sign, he definitely doesn't give it to you right away. And then sometimes you get frustrated and you're like, why aren't you giving me a sign? What am I doing wrong? I feel like I'm doing everything. You're still not giving me a sign. And I would say the sign was pretty instant. So what I learned in that moment, when God gives you a sign, you don't ignore that sign. So I got to my hotel, called my mom and dad, and said, Mom, Dad, I'm moving to LA. I'm going to move when Chris goes to school. Chris is my little brother, in the fall. They just said, okay. I think any other parent who heard their 22-year-old say they're going to move across the country on their own would have a heart attack. Filipino parents, mostly strict, will scold you if you don't go into the medical field. I am not cut out for the medical field, and I think my parents do that, and I think they did have a heart attack when I said I was leaving. I spent the entire summer applying for jobs because I'm like, okay, I really can't go to LA without a job. Didn't hear back from anyone. Here comes around end of June, the Clippers and Nickelodeon called me. I had that phone interview. I never heard back. So here comes July, still don't have a job, but I'm still going to LA because this crazy lady told me I need to follow my passion. So here's July. Hot New Hip Hop calls me. I wasn't sure who they were, but they're a big hip hop blog. The guy's name was Jason. He was also Filipino, now that I'm thinking about it. And he said, would you like to be a correspondent in Chicago? I said yes. So fast forward to August, again, I'm moving in September after my brother goes to school. And I said, Jason, is there any job openings in LA because I'm going to move to LA in September? He said, no. So he said, if you'd be interested, you can have the same job you have right now because we need a presence in LA. So I said, okay. I've worked with some of the biggest names in music. And the biggest misconception is people think just because I work with them and I'm friends with some of them that I have the same bank account as them. I do not. Hot New Hip Hop at the time was only paying me $100 an interview, and I was only doing 2 interviews a month. So when you calculate that, $200 a month in LA would probably only pay for my gas. But I was excited. I'm like, hey, it's something. I'm still moving, so here's my 22-year-old self packing up my car, have my dad and my best friend coming with me to help move, and I move to secure this bag of $200 a month. I get to LA. After I'm settled in my studio apartment in Van Nuys, I go to the Burbank Town Center, and I'm like, I really gotta find a job because $200 is just not it. So I go to Aldo, and I'm like, I wanted to see if they were hiring because I used to be a manager at Aldo when I was in high school and college. So I asked Christina, that was the manager's name at the time, and I'm like, hey, are you guys hiring? And she's like, I actually am. Can you come by on Thursday because we can meet, have coffee, and you could fill out the paperwork, it's yours. Cool, I had this job ready, first week of LA. Now this is where it gets creepy again. Here comes Thursday. I'm always late. I am the epitome of Filipino time. So I'm like running out of my apartment. I'm like, oh no, I'm gonna be late. Here's my job. I gotta get more than $200. My phone rings and it says Hot New Hip Hop. I pick up and I'm like, hey Jason. And he goes, this isn't Jason, this is Sorrow. In my head, I'm thinking, who the hell is Sorrow? Sorrow was the owner of Hot New Hip Hop. And he asked me, are you busy? I clearly was, but I'm like, maybe this is like a good thing. Told him I'm not busy, so we talked. Saro told me, Jen, out of all the correspondents we hired in the country, you were the only one who booked your own interviews, and you were the only one who didn't ask us for help. You booked more interviews than we did as a company combined, and I don't know how you did it, but I was hoping you were looking for a full-time job. Again, I was shocked. What I learned in that moment, sometimes God's not going to show you the opportunities and the blessings he has for you until you take that leap of faith and you're willing to take that risk. I accepted the job from Hot New Hip Hop that weekend. He flew from Montreal to LA that Saturday, signed the paperwork. I was good to go. My parents didn't have to take care of me. My parents didn't have to worry about me, and I was good. Everything went up from there. I was able to work for CTV. I signed a deal with Complex Media. I launched an app with Lil Wayne as the partner and the face of it. I'm sitting here thinking, it's lit. I'm never gonna have to worry about anything again. I'm good. I'm gonna keep doing what I want to do. Glad I listened to the crazy homeless lady. I was wrong. The multi-billionaire I was working for with that app, the multi-billionaire who outranked Kobe Bryant on the top richest people in Orange County, told me, you need to pick to go all in on this app or go all in on your dreams. That kind of sucked. So I'm sitting here thinking, ugh, this is the first time in LA I'm actually comfortable. I'm not living check to check. I'm not worried about anything. I'm about to meet Lil Wayne because I just got them to sign this deal. Do I put my dreams on hold and just keep this job because I don't want to struggle anymore? I don't want to have to worry about how am I going to pay rent. I don't want to have to call my mom and dad. I don't want to have to tell my friend, like, hey, can you lend me some money? So do I keep this job or do I choose my dreams that has $0 attached to it? And I chose my dreams. I quit that job because I learned there's no amount of money that's worth your passion and your happiness. So then I filed for unemployment, maxed out my credit cards, $15,000 in debt because I needed to come by. Credit score dropped pretty bad, like 575. I started to Uber, and when someone had found out I was Ubering, they had asked me, aren't you going to be embarrassed that someone's going to see you after everything that you've done? If I'm being honest with you guys, that thought absolutely crossed my mind. But then I realized I really hate social media, because the only reason people know what I'm doing or what any of us in this room is doing is because of what we're posting on social media. And social media is a lie. It's your highlight of what everything's perfect, because there is not one person in this world, I don't care how rich they are, how big they are, that is an exception to pain and struggle. So whoever it is you're worshiping and you think you want that life, you do not want that life. Then I thought, what would be even more embarrassing is giving up how hard I worked to get to this point, move back to Chicago, and leave LA. What would be more embarrassing is going to my parents, who probably didn't want me to leave for a second, and say it didn't work out. Ask them to help me, because this is the thing, my parents would have helped me. But my parents worked too damn hard for me to go up to them and say, Mom, Dad, you need to save me. I wasn't about to ask my dad, who was working 80, 90 hours at the time, my mom who worked full time, please use your check to help me. I put myself in this situation and I was gonna get myself out of it. So then everything just started to slowly kind of come back together. I hated Uber. As you can imagine, a 4'11 and a half, and I say 4'11 and a half because if I say 5 foot, everyone calls me a liar. 4'11 and a half female driving around Uber in LA. You can imagine the type of stories that I have, but I only have 15 minutes, so I'm gonna have to share that for another time. So then I went to Postmates. Postmates was new, and I'm like, okay, I don't have to deal with people. I just have to drop off their food and I can leave. So then I thought, while I'm doing this delivery, how cool would it be if artists did deliveries with me? I had no idea how to get to Postmates. So I looked on their site, I filled out their contact page. I don't remember if I told you guys earlier, I created an LLC because I didn't want to get in trouble with the IRS and I need something for a tax break. It was called DeLeon Direction. I had no clients. I submit this form to Postmates, and Postmates was my first client for DeLeon Direction. They loved the idea. They asked me to help with influencer marketing. It went so well with me that they asked if I had other artists, celebrities, and influencers that can also help with influencer marketing. I no longer had to Uber, didn't have to deliver for Postmates anymore. And in that moment, I realized all the years of building these relationships was bigger than just interviews. After Postmates, I became an agent. The first client, Lil Wayne for Float Festival, and I finally got to meet him. Booking number 2 and 3, 2 Chainz and Ludacris for the Cleveland Cavaliers in the NBA Finals. I became the chief of staff for Dash Radio, the anchor for Cheddar Music, and everything was up from there. So I say all this to say 10 years of going after my dreams, all the nights I cried, it all worked out. So I have to ask you again, what is your passion? Maybe you didn't know the answer before because you thought it wasn't possible, or maybe you don't know, and that's okay. But no matter what it is, it's going to work out for you, as long as you believe in God, believe in yourself, and follow your passion. Thank you. Thank you.